प्रणाम टू ऑल ऑफ यू। कैसे तरह बट वी चैंट वी शांतिवंत सहना हो तो देन वी इनवोक द ग्रेस ऑफ आदिशंकराचार्य एंड देन स्टार्ट। ओम सहना भवतु सहनौ भुनक्तु सह वीर्यंकरवावहै तेजस्विनावधीतमस्तु मा विद्विषावहै। ॐ शांति शांति शांतिः। ॐ सदाशिव समारंभां शंकराचार्य मध्यमां अस्मदाचार्य पर्यन्तां वंदे गुरु परंपरां। वी इनवोक द ग्रेस ऑफ द लॉर्ड एंड द गुरु एंड वी स्टार्ट थिंकिंग ऑन दिस ग्रेट टेक्स्ट। दिस इज कॉल्ड भजगोविंदम। दिस आल्सो कॉल्ड मोहा मुद्गरा। वील ट्राई टू सी व्हाट डज इट मीन। Maybe in the beginning we chant, this chanting is very familiar. So many cassettes are there, very melodious to listen to, from people who sing well, not from me. We will chant about five together and then we will take one by one and analyze what it means. I think I would request you to join because most of you know this. भज गोविंदम भज गोविंदम गोविंदम भज मूढ़मते संप्राप्ते सन्निहिते काले नहि नहि रक्षति दुक्रम करणे मूढ़दहि धनागमतुष्णां कुरु सद्बुद्धिं मनसि वितृष्णां यल्लवसे निज कर्मोपात्तं वित्तं तेन विनोदय चित्तं नारीस्तनभरणाभिदेशं दृष्ट्वा मागामोहावेशं एतत्मां सवसादिविकारं मनसि विचिन्तय वारं वारं नडनीदडगत जरमतिधरणं तत्त्वज्जीवितमतिशय चपलं विद्दिव्याध्यभिमानग्रस्तं लोकं शोकहतं च समस्तं यावत्वित्तो भाजनसक्तः सावन्निजपरिवारो रक्तः पश्चात् जीवति जर्जरदेहे मातां कोऽपि न पृच्छति एः। भज गोविंदम भज गोविंदम गोविंदम भज मूढ़मते संप्राप्ते सन्निहिते काले नहि नहि रक्षति दुक्रम करणे। लिटिल बिट ऑफ द ऑथर। He is an avatar purusha, but still it is our responsibility to remember his contribution to the Sanatana Dharma, because this was in the 7th and 8th century, where almost there was a threat to Hinduism. The other religions were there, and perhaps the Lord came out as Shankaracharya and he revived the Hinduism. No, even among the people there was clashes and there was the onslaught of Buddhism. It is at that time people had not really originally we have the Sanatana Dharma thousands and thousands of years back, but still it was under a threat. It is at that time that we had the avatar of Shankaracharya, who revived, and you know, he is the one who gave the real practical meaning, cleared the doubts in the people, and which was making them convert to the other religions. Not that he gave anything new. He wrote commentaries for the Prasthanatraya, for the Brahma Sutra, the Upanishads, and the Bhagavad Gita. These are the three prasthanatrayas. And something unique, extraordinary. And he has used Sanskrit in such a way, you know, he made it so flexible, very easily understandable. And not only he wrote these commentaries, he gave the meaning, but writing the commentary is okay. But we must understand the background. His avatar was only for around 32 years. Say this entire work has been done in about 25 years. We must see, not only he wrote commentaries, he traveled the length and breadth of this country. Even now we can imagine, to go from a place to place, how much time it takes. Kashmir to Kanyakumari, this end, that end. He established mutts and trained lots of people. And he also rejuvenated the temples. Temples rejuvenation, training people, establishment of mutts. And it's impossible to conceive that a person in about 25 years can achieve all this. It did happen. There is one reason, one background, why this text Bhaja Govindam came. There is a background. He was, Adi Shankaracharya, was going along with his disciples, 14 of them. When he was going, he saw one Pandit, Sanskrit Pandit, talking about, you know, reciting grammar. You know, we see everywhere, people mechanically chanting, not those, even though you see, mechanically right from 8 up to 80, they go on chanting. Nothing other than chanting will be happening. And when he saw this mechanical ritualistic chanting of the Vyakaranas, then he said, hey, what is this man wasting his time in these grammar rules and all that? He is wasting his entire time and this is not going to lead him anywhere. Because the whole purpose that all of us are born in this world, whether we believe or not, is for self-realization. That is the ultimate goal of life. And that is the ultimate goal. But what is this man doing mechanically? And it is at that moment came out this text called Bhaja Govindam. The one that we repeated, Bhaja Govindam, that is the first verse. And then he gave out 12 more. That's called Dwadasha Mandari Stotram. One, the original first stanza. And then the 12 more, they are called, 12 is 12, Dwadasha. Dwadasha Manjarika Stotram. The Manjarika is a bouquet. Bouquet of 12 beautiful verses he gave. And that came out, not because he wanted to write, for the sake of the upliftment of people, for the sake of helping people to realize the ultimate goal in life, out of compassion to the people, he gave out 1 plus 12, 13. Inspired by this, the 14 disciples who were with him gave one verse each, 14. That's called Chaturdasha Manjarika Stotram. Chaturdasha, 14. A bouquet of 14 beautiful verses. A bouquet of flowers, very attractive. 1 plus 12 plus 14. And then, after the conclusion of all this, Shankaracharya summed up and blessed all people of this universe with 4 more. So this makes its total 31. We will see maybe in stages all the 31. We need not go in a very tremendous hurry. We will go slowly and try to. We have been chanting, we have been listening of the cassettes of. M.S. Subbalakshmi's fantastic Bhaja Govindam is very, very melodious. And if you see, there is introduction given by Rajagopalachari. He has said, he has given the difference between the knowledge and wisdom. Knowledge we get input, when knowledge, when it is experienced by putting it into practice, then he says the wisdom will dawn in us. So we will also try to slowly go through this, not merely understand them, understand, assimilate, but more importantly experience what Adi Shankara wanted to us to experience. And this is a bouquet of 31, one introduction. As we see, we will be taking one by one these stanzas, and then slowly after each stanza, in normally in chorus, the first one is generally repeated. Perhaps we'll also follow the same technique. After each stanza we chant, so that we get the gist of this great Upanishad. Now let us try to understand what is this Bhajagovindam. So he has written other texts, you know, we have seen Viveka Chudamani, we also study here the other texts. But this is special because it's a direct, in a very small one, 31, but very, very pregnant and highly practical for us also to put it into practice. They look very, very simple. It has got the highest depth, and if you we digest and practice, then there is no reason why we should not realize ourselves in this very life, Atma Sakshatkar. This is sometimes he hits us very, very hard. Sometimes he is soft, sometimes he is very tough. What is this Bhaja Govindam? Bhaja is not doing that bhajan, and Govindam is something. Govindam is an indication of the Supreme. The ultimate reality, the consciousness, the Supreme Brahman is indicated by the word Govindam. Bhaja is not doing the bhajan. It means seek. Bhaja means seek ultimately. This is called Bhaja Govindam because this is to make us seek and attain that Supreme reality. It is called Bhaja Govindam. This is also called Moha Udgara, I told you, because Moha is called delusion. Delusion. And this delusion is to be removed, and practicing this will remove the delusion in us. So it is called Moha Mudgara. Moha Mudgara and Bhaja Govindam are the same meaning given, same, in fact it is more popularly called Moha Mudgara, but now people know it as Bhaja Govindam. We will take this first verse in chorus. Should we do it together or lead and follow? Okay.
Bhaja Govindam, Bhaja Govindam, Govindam, Bhaja Govindam, Govindam, Bhaja Mudamate, Samprapte Sannihite Kale, Nahi Nahi Rakshati Dukram Karane.
We'll chant it together.
Bhaja Govindam, Bhaja Govindam, Govindam, Bhaja Mudamate, Samprapte Sannihite Kale, Nahi Nahi Rakshati Dukram Karane.
This is an advice to us. Bhaja, seek Govinda, means realize yourself, seek the eternal, seek the consciousness, seek that Supreme Govinda. He says Govindam Bhaja Muda Mate. Let us not get offended when he tells us the word Muda Mate. He says he is calling us all fools. Oh fool, Muda Mate. Let's not get offended. He is calling all of us Mudamate. Because why does he call Mudamate? We are there. At this moment, we are not aware of that realize, the what is to be realized. So our mind is clouded. So he uses the word Mudamate. Because we are unnecessarily spending all our energies into unwanted things. A person who is doing what is not to be done by, he is obviously can be called a fool. Bhajagovindam bhajamudamate, and he says, samprapte sannihite kale. Sannihite kale. When that appointed time, with Yamaraya, when that time comes, that means when we are about to die. Samprapte sannihite kale. I think very, very simple. At the time of our death, he says, nahi, nahi, rakshati dukrum karane. Dukrum karane na rakshati. Emphasizes he. Nahi, nahi will surely, will never, he says, nahi. He emphasizes the word nahi, nahi. He uses the word twice. Surely never rakshati, what comes to your rescue or saves us, what? Dukram karane. Dukram karane, the literary meaning is grammar rules. We have to use it in a higher, larger perspective. Dukram karane, we must take it as not, it, of course it is dukram karane, means the grammar rules, but here it includes all mechanical ritualistic chanting. Mechanically people go on chanting, no? I have seen some people, they take this, after this chanting, one more chanting, and then one more chanting. Next week again, some more chanting. And in the end of the, at the, about to die also, they are the only chanting. Not a step they would have moved. Ultimately, what for it is done? Ultimate goal is to realize, if it is not done, it is this. And then, Dukram Karane is not only the grammar rules. It is all the objective senses we have to take like that. We have the physics, chemistry, mathematics, and political science, social science, you know, or engineering, medicine, economic science. All the science of the objective world is covered in this word, Dukram Karane. I think how much time we are spending? All the time. And especially students, rarely they study, but still the parents want, go, take exam, and regularly go take more marks, and get, and not only they are not happy, at the 8th, 9th level itself, they will say, come on, go to these tutorials, you must get little more marks. And somebody will tell them, go to that ACE in school, or entry exam, you have to go for CET, IIT, and there also you go on studying. And that is not sufficient. Nowadays, one more diksha is coming. They spend huge money. What for? And later on also, only study. You might have mastered, is that that I am not saying that these are not necessary. These are necessary for us to achieve, have some reasonable living in this world. But question is, what happens when we die? We learn all the objective sciences, the best of physics, chemistry, mathematics, science, medical science, all that we learn. And what use is that? Let's start thinking, at least after this, when you go home, maybe our way of handling our children or grandchildren may change. Maybe I will request some of you will become inspired and inspire at least your family people when you go. I am not saying don't say, come on, say it's all useless, don't study. No, I am not telling you to do all that. Let them study. But what use is all that study of the objective senses? Maximum what will happen? They will get a job, then they will progress in the job. Okay, afterwards what? They will acquire a little more big job, greater job. And afterwards what? In the United States, when credit cards, you buy house, car and permanently credit. India, you also go buying all these things which are requirement, require house, latest TV. TVs will be changing every moment. We had those, we had plasma and then LCDs came, LEDs came. Now the latest smart TV, more than 3-4 lakhs TV with them. All that you go. And ultimately what? Ultimately for what? To suffer. It is not that it is not necessary. This, all the things in this world that we acquire, if the objective sense and which will help us to acquire things of this world, what will happen? When I die, nothing will come. You know, the houses that we have, fortunately it won't come. I have to leave the house, the bank balance, the balance in my own account where I can show, the account in the Swiss banks and maybe in Mauritius. We don't know where we kept, and none of them will come with us. Then he says, why are you doing all this? He is not saying don't do that, but these things, the objective senses and the material that we get from the development of, please don't mistake me, I am not, or Shankaracharya ji is not against growth. Our standards of living has to increase. It has to increase. But is it enough? That is not adequate. Because all these things that we hold, acquire, protect and hold, none of them will come with us when we leave this world. When we depart, each one of us will depart. All these things, you know, the wealth that we have, why wealth? The body that we have, body will leave and go, which is made out of the panchabhutas, they will remain here. And how much of time, how much of this we would have spent time in nourishing this body? Majority of the money that we get, we spend in upkeep of this body. Look at that, how much we have spent for the sake of this body? The dress that we wear, the comforts that we give, all for the sake of the body only. The comfort of the chair for the body, the TV, comfort for the mind, like that. Look at that, all the money, the car, the house, the man, all we do for the sake of the body, which will not come. All the body will not come, the wealth will not come, even the friends and relatives also will not come. When we depart, what progress we have made spiritually only will come even after our death. There we say each one of us have what is called as a PAN number. Permanent account number. Permanent account number, the papa and punya alone will be transferred. And there, fortunately and unfortunately, there is no transfer between the husband and the wife also. My account is my own. My wife's account. Here you may have joint accounts. Or you may write a will, it will go to my legal or illegal hands. It can go to anybody. But this is my own. The progress spiritual we have made is our own. This is, he calls us, calls from the top of this. He says, this what you are doing, dukram karane, not only the grammar rules, all the objective senses, all the wealth that we project, that we possess, the body, the relatives and the wealth, none of them samprapte sannihite kale nahi rakshati dukram karane. Then what? He says, bhaja govindam, bhaja govindam, govindam bhaja mudamate. So let's not get offended when he calls us fools. I think we deserve to be called mudas. So how to reach them? To reach them, there is what is called a number of methods of approaching. Our Vedanta gives, there are 9 types of process of progressing in this world. All of you know it very well. It is called Shravanam, and then we say kirtanam, smaranam, padasevanam, archanam, vandanam, dasyam, sakyam, atma nivedanam. These are the 9 steps of reaching my own nature or self-realization. So here he tells us from the top of the world, our business is, we are born in this world with the ultimate goal of self-realization. We have to seek that, and because none of these rules will going to help us, none of the rules do. That is why let us go on chanting, but let us not end in chanting. Even this Bhajavangam also should not become one more chanting. While saying chanting, and we go on chanting Bhajavangam, it doesn't help. What he says is, seek him, do the sadhana, don't get stuck with the mechanical rituals, mechanical chanting. So let us go to the second verse. The next 12 are given by Shankaracharya. Moodajahihi danagama trishnam. Please take it in chorus. Kuru sad buddhim manasi vitrishnam. Yallabhase nija karma bhattam. Vittam tena vinodaya chittam. We'll take it once more. Mooda jahihi danagama trishnam. Kuru sad buddhim manasi vitrishnam. Yallabhase nija karma bhattam. Vittam tena vinodaya chittam. Again, bhaja govindam, bhaja govindam, govindam bhaja mudamate, samprapte sannihite kale, nahi nahi rakshati dukram karane. Here he is telling us, is not difficult to understand. This is almost a biography of all of us. He says, Mooda, let us not go fool. He calls us rightly. Jahihi dana agama trishna. Dana agama trishna is the thirst to possess wealth. Dana agama trishna is that thirst. Dana agama, to possess wealth. To possess wealth, all of us have the thirst. And then he says, Jahihi. Give up. Give up that thirst to possess wealth. And then what? Kuru sadbuddhim manasi vitrushna. Manasi vitrushna, he says, in the mind, devoid of all this passion with Krishna, he says, Kuru Sat Buddhim. So clear, Shankaracharya is so clear. He says, Sat Buddhim, the thought of reality, put it in the mind or create in your mind. He says, Kuru Sat Buddhim Manasi with Krishna. With Krishna is get rid of the divide of the passions, put, create in yourself that thoughts of that supreme, thoughts of the reality, and then what else has to be done? Yallabhase nija karma upattam. We are going to do some job, karma. Because of the job that we are going, karma upattam, we get some return. We get some reward. With that reward, which we get out of the right way of working, whatever yet lavase, whatever you get, what? Nija karma upattam. Very, very. See, if this is followed, our whole country will become one of the best countries of the world. this alone is enough for uplifting this country. What is nija karma upattam yate labase, what vittam, whatever money that you get, do your job extremely well, and whatever reward you get tena vittam, with that money, he says chittam vinodaya, make your mind, entertain your mind, may you be content with what you get out of what you do. Let's analyze this little more. He says mudaha, because we are again going after wealth and we are only trying to satisfy this body, and he says we are not having not only this, there is no end for muni. Who is happy with what one has? People, we have a few lakhs, they say, I am not too much. If I just 10 lakhs, it is enough. But those who get 10 lakhs, they want 1 crore. 1 crore, are people happy? 10 crores, 100 crores, 200 crores. Just you see all around our own Karnataka, people with thousands of crores and thousands of acres of land, are they satisfied? Ask them. In fact, they are more thirsty. It is like a fire, small fire, little ghee. Fire becomes big, you want a bigger amount of ghee, so and so, more and more wealth, it becomes more and more greedy. This is called Trishna, the thirst for acquiring more and more wealth, and there is no end. Even in power also, who is happy with the power? They become, by some method, top, they would have become DG and IGP, one level below. I have got only 1 or 2 months for retirement. Still, I want that seat. The two people fought and both of them retired. But look at the fight. Could they not be happy with that one lawyer? After all, there are constables, lowest people. If he gets one level of people are not happy with that power. We don't ask, go and ask them, are you happy? No. People initially say, it is sufficient, I become one corporator. Afterwards, they say, no, I must become at least MLA. All right, 220 and that. You become MLA, are you? No. I want to become different days, cabinet minister only. And then in the cabinet, no, that particular portfolio. Ask them if they are happy. No. Each one of them wants to become CM. Actually, these 500 MPs, you know, most of them, it seems, they went to their own favorite gods. They said, Lord, people are asking this and that. We are very, very simple people. Just interchange the alphabet. I am an MP. Make me a human. Is a person happy that he becomes MP? Look at that. It is extremely difficult to find a person who is in office also. You have seen promotion. Nobody is happy with the position. Nobody is happy with the promotion. What is happening is there is this thirst, and this desire is not satisfied. Because the desire is not satisfied, what happens? The result? Result is unhappy. Unhappy. Happiness, my spiritual master, Pujya Swami Chinmayanandi said, Gurudev said, happiness is an interval between two desires. Happiness is an interval between two desires. I have got a cycle. I am not too very ambitious. If I get one moped, I will be happy. When he gets a moped, he is about to become happy. Then he will say, at least I must have 100cc bike. That, I am not asking too much, at that moment. When he is getting that bike, when he is about to become happy, at least I must have one car, at least one lower guarded car, 1 lakh, 1.5 lakh, that car. Because I want one cover, that is all. Okay, when it comes, is happy? No, no, I want a bigger body car. Then even if you have a fleet of cars, you know, you will see everywhere, you are in many houses, you will see a fleet of cars. Ask them, are you satisfied? No. This desire cannot be satisfied. He says, it is number one, when I have, what is happening is, I have a desire. When the desire is satisfied, I desire. And till I attain the desire, I am unhappy. After getting the desire, one more happy. So there is no scope for me to be happy. He says, Trishna Mudaha Jahihi, because it is making you unhappy. You see, all of us want two things, Sukha Prapti, Dukkha Nivruti. That is all. The ultimate purpose of all of us is, I want Sukha, I don't want Dukkha. Sukha Prapti, Dukkha Nivruti. I think all of us of all ages, we need. But what is happening is, this Krishna is killing us, that, and there is no end. And people go on begging. But there are some people, you know, there was, I do not know when I shared with you, there was a person who was in the forest, and one king came. When he king came, he was about to get God from a wild animal, and at that moment this man killed, and the king was saved. King was saved, then obviously he had gratitude. He says, he announced himself, I am the king, so and so, you are the one who saved, and who really king is. Then when you come to the kingdom, I'll give you whatever you want. He says, no, I don't want. No, when you come. He forgot, but after some time, when he was in real difficulties, his wife pushed him, hey, you are king, go. Oh, anyway, he went to the palace. But king had already told his people in the palace that a person of this particular description might come, give him all. When he went there, the king was not in the palace. When the people saw the description, hey, he is the man Kung has been telling. He said, now king is in the temple, go and meet there. He was led into the temple. And there the king was, praying and asking. The man just saw the king and simply started going off. And later on people told me, sir, that man had come. Oh, come on, raise him. They went, they brought him. Then the king asked him, hey, why are you running away? But I will give it. Sir, I came to beg you something, but I found you are a greater beggar. Why this beggar should ask him directly? There is no end, friend, dear friends, for the, so he says, number one, there is no end for the Trishna, for the thirst of, here we should include, thirst for all the material wealth. He says, Manasi with good, then what he must do, because this is going to create this, this is done with a purpose. More and more thirsty we are of the external world, more and more our mind will get disturbed. There is Naraka here only. Naraka is nowhere else. Is it not because of the thirst of Krishna? We are seeing a queue of people into that Parappana Graharajai. Is that difficult to understand? Is it not? Are they all the latest group of people who are going to that? Are they all not people very comfortably placed? They had more and more thirst. It is that which they have made them land in a Naraka. He says, this they are doing, but we are doing in a different scale. That's all. As far as we are also doing like that, they are wanting thousands of crores, we may want little more, that's all. This thirst, he says, leave it away. Then what else? Make your mind calm, okay? Then, Kuru Sat Buddhim Manasi Vitrishna. When the mind is free from the passion, then what? Turn your mind towards the higher. Because when the mind is going always outside to the outside world of objects, world of emotions and thoughts, when it is gushing out like this, there is no scope for it to go up. He says, then first step is remove. And then Sadguru Sat Buddhim. Think of the reality in your mind. And then, okay, then question is, what should we do? We should we stop working? And should we stop asking for something to happen? He says, no. Do it. But he says, do your job. When you do your job, you are going to get some reward. He says, yar labase nija karma upatam. When you do a job, you get a reward. Whatever vittam should include all the rewards that we do for our job. When we work in this world, don't expect anything, but some reward will come. When that whatever comes, he says, what he says, tena vittam, with that money, what he has to do? Vinodaya chittam, entertain your mind. Be happy, enjoy, be blissful. That will come only when I am contented. When there is no contentment, whatever I have, I will suffer. The same house, the same vehicle, the same bank balance, the same husband or wife, if I am not happy, I will never be happy. You don't say, if I have that, I will be happy. I should have married her. You are already 60. You are now thinking of what you should have done 38 years back. Forget it. Whatever thing you have, whatever the Lord has given to us, entertain your mind, make your mind. So when that content will come? If it does not come today, the 4th of June, don't expect it to come on the 5th of June. Today, Monday, the 4th of June, 2012, if I am not happy with what I have got by my honest and sincere work, another day I can never be happy. So I think today we have to celebrate happy birthday. Because we are going to make our mind happy. Why? My happiness does not depend on anything. But whatever I have, I am contented with what we have. Friends, it is for us to be happy. That Shankaracharya says, whatever you have. And then it is also said that we will never get happiness. He says, if we think that I am going to become happy by any other position, it shall never happen. We also saw in this own this thing, Ishavasya, it says, tena viktena bunjita magruda kasya siddhanam. He says, renounce, enjoy, covet not others' help. That means, be there. Let us caution ourselves. I should not run away. It doesn't mean that I must retire to either Vanaprastha or Sannyasa. Let us be here in this world. There is nothing wrong with the world. There is nothing wrong with the wealth. Nothing wrong. I must be inside, but I shall not get attached, or I shall not get affected, influenced. Instead of allowing that to control me, I should control the wealth. I hope we understand. Please don't misunderstand that I should run away from the house. Oh, see, we should not have everything, but have it under your control. It's something like this. This is also one, as once Gurudev was saying, it seems there was one a father and son. They had gone to, a ground where there was a parade and procession and all that. There they found the father is there, along with him that young son is there. There they found the one person who was being hunted. He had conducted lot of dacoities, murder, innumerable number of rape cases, and he had again missed, and then finally they caught him. That man was being taken to the jail. That is a familiar sight that we see everywhere. And around him, there were policemen. because you know he was the most sought after criminal because he had done lots of murders, rape, burglary and all that. They wanted to play safe, all the policemen were around him. God. And this child asked, "Dad, what? Why there are so many policemen around?" He said, "Hey, he is the criminal of the highest order. That is why they are being surrounded." Went away. Afterwards, sometime after a few days, there was one more gang going. There in the center was a person surrounded by people of all the army, military and all the policemen. That was the president of India. Around them there were this. And the son immediately said, "Dad, you see, one more murderer. Wait, you told me when a person is surrounded, he is a criminal murderer. See, a greater criminal because more people are there." He said, no. "Hey, you said." "Yeah, the situation is different. There in the first case, these people were controlling, who? The policeman. But he is the commander of all the forces, the president of India. He controls them. He is not a criminal." Let us understand. Our world is there. We are inside. Either I can be like the president of India, control things around me, or like a criminal. So let us not, when he says, "Leave away dhanagama trishna jahihi," not that he is not telling us to run away from the world, but only what he says, Shankaracharya ji says, don't get influenced, don't be under the control of the wealth. Have it under your own control. So then have it under control, be in this world, but do your duty. And again, our Vedanta doesn't say, come on, sit, simply go on doing meditation. No, do your job. See, what a fantastic, this has got all science of sciences in this particular verse. Yat labhase nija karma upatam vittam tena vinodaya chittam. This is called kanchana. Money. Let us go to the next one. Naristanabharanabhidesham. Please repeat. Drushtva maga mohavesham. Etat mam savasadivikaram. Manasi vichintaya varam varam. Once more, we'll take it. Nari stanabara nabhi desham. Drushtva maga mohavesham. Etat mam savasadivikaram. Manasi vichintaya varam varam. Bhaja Govindam, Govindam, Bhaja Mudamate, Samprapte Sannihite Kale, Nahi Nahi Rakshati, Dukram Karane. Nari of the ladies or the maidens, Sanabara, their bosom, Bhara, the weight, a well-built bosom, Nabhi Idesham, the navel, Santa. This is, he is describing one which is attractive to our senses. Let us understand, it is not restricted to a lady only. Lady attraction not only towards the ladies, but overall, Nari, he is only giving an example. Nari, the ladies, with the whether attractive bosom and a thin navel. Drushtva, having seen that, magha moha vesham. Don't fall a prey into the delusion. That means the previous text, previous verse was about Kanchana, the wealth. This is a description of Kamini. Kanchana, Kamini. Kamini, we have to understand as attraction towards the other sex. It includes attraction of the male towards the female or females to the males. Though the description of the woman is given, we have to understand, in other words, at sensual pleasure attraction. He says there will be things which will attract your mind, the shape of the body, and but don't fall a prey, though it is likely to trap you. It is going to trap you. Drushtva moda moha vesham. Then what you must do? Dissect and find out what is that that you are getting to. Either whatever you are getting attracted to that body, mamsa, flesh, vasa, fat, mamsa, vasa, adi, etc. Mamsa, vasa, adi, vikara. It is just but modification of the flesh and the fat. No, in the it is not that it is in the older young ages only. In any age, this is a flesh, the shape of the body is likely to attract. Of course, people get attracted to the shape of the body, and some people get is called attraction to the hardware. Some people get attracted to the cover of the hardware also. What nice dress he is wearing, what nice dress she is wearing. We get attracted either to the hardware or initially to the cover on the hardware. And he says, hey, what is it is making, it is trapping you. Then he says, be careful. What? Look at that. This, what is that which is the, I am getting attracted to daily, you will see, between 10 and 10:30. What is that? In all the channels, crime story, crime story, crime reporter, crime story, crime diary, crime, majority of them is, you will see, is because of the boy and the girl. And it is making you fall a prey. He says, Ari Stanabarana Videsham Drushtva Maga Mohavid. The two things he has indicated. Physical body is likely to attract. Don't fall a prey to that. Analyze it. What is that, after all, that shape you are getting attracted? The Miss Universe, the Miss World. What is, after all? It is a shape of what? Mamsa and Vasa. Nothing but flesh and fat wrapped in a skin. The cover. In something like a presentation, you know, give you this, what things which are, which you don't want, which others unnecessarily gave it to you, you pack it in a nice and give it to somebody in a marriage, you know. And that cover is beautifully done. Like that, the skin Lord has used that. Just, he says, come on, remove that skin and see. I think you will run away the moment this outer packing wrapper of the skin is removed. I think you will run away from that place. After that is that you are getting attracted to it. Mamsa vasadi vikaram. He says, manasi vichintaya. What? Think. Think, not only think, think well. When? Varam, varam. Again and again think, what is that I am falling attracted to? So this is a natural attraction. Natural attraction is happening, but in this we forget our, this, you see, we have to take not only the man's attraction to a woman or a woman's attraction. This previous word was about Kanchana. This is Kamini, indicating of all that is attractive to our sensual pleasures. All the outer things which are my senses are attracted to, in majority of the cases, it is this which is going to cause our downfall. What is pleasant to the eyes, what is pleasant temporarily to the ears, the nose, tongue and the skin, what we talked was about the look. Some people get attracted to the touch of a man or a woman, or by some things. All these, this indication is Kamini indicates all that attracts our five organs of perception, senses, and majority of the cases this is going to be our own downfall. It is said even in the animals, what is attractive towards it will cause its own death. You know, the during rain that will come, that fall, that is its own downfall. Each pest or an animal has got one which will attract. That attraction alone will cause its downfall. But one is sufficient. What about for us? All the five senses are powerful. We are at the weaknesses of getting attracted to five openings. Then there is a greater danger that we are going to. He says, careful, be careful. Seeing that, when you see now, why are we getting attracted? Number one, we are getting attracted towards the senses in the world because I think, all of us get attracted because we think that is permanent, number one. Number two, we think that that is going to give me happiness. These are the two wrong beliefs, that the things outside, whatever is there, is number one, permanent. Number two, it is going to make me happy. But this is false, because if the happiness, my happiness is in the outside world, increase in that should make me more happy. It is not happening. It is something like that. If I got, suppose I like rasgulla. One rasgulla, so much happiness. Two more, five more, 10, 15 will make me vomit. Similarly, anything more and more, this is called what Pujya Gurudev Chimmandi calls this as law of diminishing returns. The happiness will not increase with more and more, more and more, afterwards it will not, it is in fact causes nauseation, vomiting. Number one, increase in the outer world, our objects of the world, which my senses get attracted to, is not going to make me happy. And then second is, it is not permanent. All the outside things are temporary. And he says, analyze it. And again, go behind what it is there. It is something like this. Suppose you, I'll give you a crudest example. Suppose you are a fan, you like masala dosa. And you know, I understand that even persons like our D.V. Gundappa, since he had that love for that special masala dosa of MTR. You know, Vidyarthi Bhavan, in, and he used to enjoy this. He describes how beautifully that butter and all. Maybe, suppose you have that weakness of masala dosa. If you want to get over, once you go inside the kitchen and see how they are manufacturing that masala dosa, that's there, that broom. The masala, they do it with their legs. The moment you see inside, you never anymore eat that masala dosa. Once you see how it is prepared. Similarly, you are getting attracted. Nari sthanabara navi desham drushtva maga mohavisham mamsa vasali. It is nothing but the fat and the flesh covered by a skin. The moment you remove, you get jigupsa. When you are not, same way, this world is like that. Looks attractive because of the wrapper or the covering. The moment you really know what is inside, you will start running away. He says, do it again and again. It is not that, again, Shankaracharya doesn't say, running away, running away, running away. He keep a mental distance. Don't run away physically having the strong desire in the mind. Try to outgrow the desire. This is what is to be, let's understand this. Oh, it's done. I should be out of sense. My mind is always saying, have one more masala, have one more dagadaga. But I will say, no, I will not do. But mind is asking. Instead of this Kurukshetra, have one more. But ideally, out of understanding that this masala dosa is horrible, it is prepared unhygienically, and it is not going to, it is going to be bad for my BP and for my sugar and cholesterol and all that. No. Then out of understanding, then you develop the dislike or develop whatever you are getting attracted, get rid of it out of mental outgrowing the desire, then you will not suffer. This we have to extend to all the kamini. Kamini, we have to understand all the attraction of the senses. He says, understanding that, number one, they are not permanent. They are not going to be happiness. My happiness is not outside. My happiness is inside. In fact, Shankaracharya says, my nature is happiness. There is, I am Satchidananda Swarupaha. I am the Supreme Bliss Paramananda. I am the consciousness. But I am thinking that I am the body. And all the requirements of the body according to me are my requirements. All the requirements of my mind is my requirement. All I am trying to satisfy my intellect, because I am thinking that I am the body, I am the mind, I am the intellect. I am trying to satisfy, I am the body, my body wants, my mind wants, my intellect wants. The moment I understand I am not the body, I am not the mind, I am not the intellect, that won't come. Because unless, and then if I am not the mind, I am not the mind, I am not the intellect, who am I? I am the Atman, I am the spirit, I am the consciousness, I am the other. When that dawns, then I will automatically, I will not be suppressing. Chimandi uses the word, don't suppress desires, sublimate them, outgrow the desires. After understanding that this does not give me, he says, outgrow it and be in self. Then what I must do? Bhaja Govindam. Bhaja Govindam. Govindam bhaja mudapade. Samprapte san nihide kale nahi nahi rakshati dukram karne. Again, with that background, you read the last one. Kanchana does not help. The kamini means all the sensual pleasures that I am, my sense organs of perception are trying to seek, none of them will come with me even after my death. And what is with me? Is with me, was with me, will with me, and that supreme bliss consciousness. He says, seek that bhaja govindam. And I repeat, it should not be a suppression. This is where we have to spend lot of time. Again, when we chant this, while we are saying dukram karane, that is again not mechanically ritualistic chant. It is easy to remember in the poem form. And that is why it is easier to remember. Even Sanmanya Diviji also says, Kagga I have given, because it is easy to remember in a poetic form. So for that purpose we will use it. But we continuously chant this Mohamudgara or Bhaja Govindam. But when we chant, we try to make an auto suggestion that we are not going to merely understand, but we are going to implement it. So the two verses that we are now, we are not going to get affected by the wealth outside. We are not going to get affected by the sensual pressures. I will ensure that the mind does not go outside, but I will be inside. Because this, I want sukha, I don't want dukkha. Sukha prapti I want, dukkha nivritti. But I want sukha prapti, but I don't want dukkha. But my direction of going is dukkha. Outside world is giving me dukkha. Temporarily it might give me a pleasure. But the moment that is gone, power gives me position. The moment position power gone, I was the CM, I had pressure. The moment gone, dukkha. Anything outside is temporary, and temporarily I have pressure, it gives me misery. So understanding this, we will have a different way of life. We will continuously practice what we have seen. We will chant these three once more, and then we will see the next verses in the next classes.
Bhaja Govindam, Bhaja Govindam, Govindam Bhaja Mudamate, Samprapte Sannihite Kare, Nahi Nahi Rakshati Dukram Karane, Mudajahihi Dhanagama Trushnam, Kuru Sat Buddhim Manasi Vitrushnam, Yallavase Nija Karmopattam, Vittam Tena Vinodaya Chittam, Bhaja Govindam, Bhaja Govindam, Govindam Bhaja Mudamade, Samprapte Sannihite Kale, Nahi Nahi Rakshati Dukram Karane, Nari Stana Bharanabhi Desham, Drushtva Magha Mohavesham, Etatmam Savasadi Vikaram, Manasi Vichintaya Varam Maram, Bhaja Govindam, Bhaja Govindam, Govindam Bhaja Mudamate, Samprapte Sannihite Kale, Nahi Nahi Rakshati Dukram Karane.
Thank you very much. 6 minutes we have. Any questions? 2-3 minutes we can discuss. If there is a... Thank you for the opportunity given to me to these studies, because it, when I speak, I have repeatedly stressed, it is not going to make anybody wiser, because you are all very wise people. I improve myself by speaking. That's all the purpose. Bhaskar, any questions we can answer? Dukram Karane, normally it means Vyakaran Shastra. Vyakaran Shastra. But mere Vyakaran Shastra is not going to help. But in this particular context, all the objective sciences, in the beginning we said science, mathematics, medical, engineering, political, all the knowledge of the outside world is called Dukram Karane. Paravidya. Aparavidya is this. The outside world, all the senses, it might help little economy of the country, and that is all. It is not going to help me, that is all. We have to also take it as mechanical ritual chanting also won't help. He had one acharya called Kavya Kanta Ganapati Mahamuni. He is one who was well versed, eloquent. He used to chant all the Vedas, Upanishads, Ramayana, Mahabharata, one of the most eloquent, and all everything was in Kanta. So he was called Kavya Kanta Ganapati Mahamuni. The scholar who knew everything, all the chanting, bada 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 bada, Vedas, Upanishads, Brahma Sutra, but he was miserable, he says. He went to Bhagavan Ramana Maharshi. Bhagavan Ramana Maharshi. Ramana Maharshi did not, he was a college dropout. He didn't have a formal education of the Vedas, Upanishads. He didn't have any regular spiritual group. But he was, at 16 years, he was an evolved soul. He goes to himself, he has sought. Bhagavan, he used to, Venkat Ramana was being called Ramana Maharshi. Bhagavan, he says, I know all things, but I am miserable. In spite of knowing all the sciences, all the Vedas, Upanishads, Brahma Sutra, bada bada bada, but I am miserable. I am unhappy. These guys. Then Bhagavan Ramana Maharshi initiates him. This Vikram Karane is not going to help. Meditate. Find out. He says, I know all. I know Upanishad. He says, go to the root. when you say I, what is that I? Try to find out. When you are saying I know, I can chant, I, what is that I? Try to find out that I. The moment you realize that I, that is how that Kavya Kanta Ganapati Muni realizes under Bhagavan Ramana Maharshi. So Ramana Maharshi did not have he had Dukram Karani, Devamani. And most of us are like that in this world. Padapadapadapadapadapada chanting, Rikshita Sahasranama, Leta Sahasranama, this chanting, that chanting, daga daga we do it. It's nothing wrong. But sooner or later, quickly we must understand what is it meaning, and I must put it into practice. That is what is Dukram Karani. Like Kavya Kanta Ganapati Muni, and chanting doesn't help. Let us find out who am I. That is what is this. I hope we have answered, Amma.
There will be English discourse by Usha Amani on the subject.